Okay, that looks very close. Yep, that's a close enough starting point right there. Yeah, that looks really good. And here I didn't even come in all the way in and touch that original edge, but I'll get that with the diamond stones. But you can see now that's a very very close to 25 degrees to reset that bevel. Let's see how this one looks. Yeah, that's very close. I may be just a little high on the heel, but I'm willing to live with it. That's, you know, that's a half a degree or something out. And we'll probably be able to straighten it out with the extra coarse stone, the extra coarse diamond stone. That's what we're going for, you know, to regrind this back to a good working starting point of 25 degrees. Clean facet all the way across, as close as we can get. And of course we're also checking for squareness too, and trying to address that as much as possible before we go to the stones. You know, we want to take off the least amount of material as possible. We want to do as much grinding as we can here on this aggressive green wheel. This is one that has not been touched at all. I hadn't done any pre-grinding on it. It's got a real nice, sharp, clean facet, but I loosened up the protractor head so we can actually determine what the angle that it is. And that looks like it's, you know, over the course of many, many sharpenings, it looks like it's about 33 degrees. And that's too steep now. So let me put it back to 25, and you can just see how radical. Radically, you know, 7 degrees, what a radical difference 7 degrees makes. Look at that. So that's 7 degrees in there of difference. So let me grind this guy back. I can't take it. And then I've got a couple more that I'll grind on the belt sander. But I'm gonna do this one right now, right here. So I got the posts and the angle of this guide assembly adjusted to where, you know, I'm just going to use this white line as my reference line, because I'm going to just freehand this guy. And so, you know, I'm pretty close right here to my 25 degrees. So I'm going to be just on the inside of this machined cast iron member right here. And but you can see how much of the heel that I have to grind off of this to get it to 25, but let me just get on with it so you can see. So the other ones I had kind of pre-ground to, but this one is one that was, you know, a completely clean facet from working. It actually feels pretty sharp, but I'm gonna go ahead and take care of it and grind it back, so they're all gonna be ready to at the same stage. Here's my first touch into it. Look how much material that removes so quickly. I mean, that's just pure steel right there. It a little bit too much on this side, so I need to make sure that I favor this side a little bit now.
looking good.
So you can see how quickly you can remove material without any danger of overheating your steel with this machine. Really can pound on some water too if you're doing this kind of aggressive cutting. All the way up to the front. And while I'm holding this, I can't even feel the knife change temperature. Okay, so I need to put a little bit more pressure on this side, on this inside. And let me check my angle. See if I'm getting... Yeah, I could still remove a little bit more off that heel. A little bit more on this inside. Good. Straightening that out a little bit more over here. That's not bad. A little high on that heel, but I'm willing to live with that. Squareness there is not too bad. I think if I just come off a little bit farther, I'll clip that heel a little bit more, and I'm going to straighten this out and hopefully get that end and be done with this grinding. Good. A little bit up here. That's pretty hard to improve upon. I'll get that little bit when I sharpen. Maybe I'll just get rid of it right now. I'll just touch it real quick. that looks real good there. That I got that high mark off that. It's gonna be a lot fewer strokes to get rid of it. Let me see if I got closer to my angle now. That's pretty good. You know, come on.